Alright, what is up, everybody? Mad Hooter here once again. Man, how do you not get cranked up when you hear that stuff? Definitely one of the coolest soundtracks ever, in my mind. Good and the Bad and the Ugly. There's super twangy guitar on there. It's cool, let's check it out. Awesome. I love that whole genre of Western movies. And of course, you see I got my Val Kilmer up there. That version of Tombstone, it was still fluffy and maybe not entirely accurate, but it was still a good movie. I enjoy it. Every time it pops up or whatever, I watch it. Val Kilmer was awesome in it. I mean, how do you not like Doc Holliday, you know? Super cool. So anyway, enough jawing about that. Let's get to what's up for me today. So, as you'll see in the title, outrage culture is a problem. And I think it sucks. And the reason why is because so much of it, it's not just the social justice warriors or whatever. You just have, like, everybody, even people that are on the right, and freak out about everything. But it's mostly now the outrage culture thing. It has consumed the left to just dominated it to where everybody just trips out over every little thing. And it's all based on emotion. There's very little rational thought that goes into it. Or just like anybody just taking a minute to say, okay, what's going on? You know, the whole, like the deal, the Billy Bush tapes, you know, Trump on the bus. Everybody knows what he said, where people were like, oh my God, that's it. Trump has ruined it. I was like, okay, there was a language alert in there. But, you know, the key in that whole thing was, he says they let you do them, and anybody that's ever been in a popular band or been to rock and roll shows or anything or seen how people trip out over celebrities, it doesn't matter if you look like Andy Dick, chicks will still fall on you. I mean, this whole Aziz thing where he's, I mean, maybe it's not that bad, but it does sound like he's kind of a jerk, but it's not, definitely not a reason to outrage. And that's one of my problem with this whole outrage culture. It's like, remember, maybe some of you aren't old enough, but you know, in the 80s and 90s, there was this whole thing about devil worshiping, and you know, you're Satanist or whatever if you listen to Iron Maiden or Danzig or whatever, you know. And I was one of those kids coming to school and I had the Danzig shirt, you know, the upside down cross and all that stuff, and people were outraging over that. And it was people on the right who were like, you know, they were morally threatened. It's like the whole moral panic thing. And so now we're in this new thing to where it's like PC culture has driven this new moral panic era, and it's got people who used to be liberal to where they're like, you know, they didn't really care what you said or whatever. It was cool. You know, nobody was wanting to be censored or anything. And now people are totally becoming pro-censorship. You can't say that. You can't even say you support the president without being beaten over the head. Or being called a name or whatever. And it's all based on emotion, because, like, how could you be? Because, you know, sex has been, you can't support the president or whatever. You can't even say anything positive. Which I've told everybody, I'm not the biggest Trump supporter. There are things that he's done that I completely disagree with. But then there's stuff that he's done that's like, okay, I'm pretty good with that. And as far as for what he says, I don't care about his fucking tweets. I don't. Him and Kim Jong-un can go back and forth all they want. Ill-un, whatever. I don't care. And everybody's like, you know, the people that are, there's the panic again, the more, Trump's gonna start a nuclear war. Like, dude, you don't understand. Have you not heard that the toys that they have, which are basically toys compared to what we have, we can turn North Korea into glass. Kim Jong-un is basically waving, you know, a firecracker at the United States, who's got the bombs. By the way, say hi to Sam. It's Sam over there. Come here, dummy. There he is. Did you get your face up there? No. Everybody's got to have a dog, you know? I'm a cat person, too, but I'm pretty much like all animals, but dog's a good thing. It's kind of like that home safety thing. Get an alarm system, get a dog, get a gun. Anyway, so the outrage culture has turned into this knee-jerk thing to where everybody's just like, oh, freak out, panic, panic, panic. And then they get on, you know, social media and they virtue signal the hell out of it. Cannot believe, cannot believe. Oh my God, this is so true. It's the worst thing in the world ever. And I was like, no, it's not, man, because you jump in your car and go to work and the same crap's going to happen. Maybe you'll talk about it, the water cooler or whatever. But like, for people to flip out over every little thing, it just makes the actual real issues seem insignificant. Because, you know, it's like the boy that cried wolf thing over and over again. I can't believe it. Can't believe it. Oh, my God. And now people who used to be fairly balanced, liberal, true liberal people have lost their minds because they're jumping on the trend. Oh, we got to outrage over everything. We have to fix this. We got to fix that. And black people and cops. And then, like, come on, man. Can't you screw your head back on? Think about stuff before you just freak out. They've turned into like old school moms, you know, like, oh, we better not, you know, we have to have like, you know, it's going to be, they're trying to turn us into like homogenized society to where, you know, we all have like gender non-specific uniforms that we march around in. And, you know, we don't ever say anything that's off of the tracks, you know. You got to stay in your lane, and that's boring. And that's why people say, oh, we need a socialist utopia. And I was like, okay, yeah, that sounds good if you're fucking high. What do you mean a social utopia? Venezuela, to where my dog could be my next meal or my last meal? Socialist utopia, what do you mean? What do you mean where we have socially built everything to be completely a level playing field, to where we have the proportionate amount of blacks, Asians, whites, everything. We are very homogenous. We all look the same. We are nobody. None of us are ever different, ever. What are you talking about? That is not utopia. Utopia is where you let people be free to be who they want to be. You want to be the guy that lives under the bridge? On a cardboard box? Fine. You want to be Donald Trump? Fine. You are allowed to do that. Or Elon Musk or whatever. Or if you just want to be a musician that talks shit on YouTube, you're allowed to do that. That's utopia, where you're allowed to be free. And you should also have the right to be offended by something that somebody says, like what I say to you. But I also, by that having that right to offend you, you also have the right to offend me back. And I also have the right to go, don't care. Later. Bye. I throw my leg over my bike and grab a handful and I'm gone. Don't care what you say. I really don't. I mean, especially if you're like the random person, you know, getting on my Facebook page and blah, 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 blah. Look at you, you know, on a motorcycle, trying to be a big man, huh? I'm like, no, I'm trying to do something that I enjoy. And I really don't give a crap if you enjoy it or not. Where I do start becoming bothered is when you basically try to run me over or cut me off in your stupid, you know, Prius or whatever. Or your Volvo. I had a lady a couple months ago damn near flatten me and driving her Volvo, and it had coexist stickers on it. And she gave me the finger. It had the nerve to give me the finger while she cut me off. But did I go home in outrage over it? No. And I was like, well, that was good. I'm not dead, so later. You know, I understand, you know, school shootings, things, these things happen. But in the overall picture, it's not a giant. We don't live in a overly outright, overtly dangerous society. We just don't. Yes, because we have 350 million or so people here. Yes, bad things are going to happen. Yes, they are an issue. We should figure out how to solve these issues. But to just blow it out of proportion and say, 18 school shootings, since the first of the year, whatever, which is not true. And that's the part of the problem is mainstream media is driving this outrage culture with twisted, either outright lies or twisted facts. So they take these stats and they manipulate them to fit the narrative. So the outragers will get on YouTube or social media and flip out. And then they get even more flipped out when somebody goes, "Hey man, that's not exactly accurate at all." So then they outrage more and like, "You're a monster because you don't think that blah 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 and school shootings and then cops are murdering people in the streets and then blah, blah." They're just like the guy back in the 80s that we all used to laugh at with his Bible and like, "You should do what this good book says." And they got their snakes out and they're doing it and they're jiggling their beads and they're doing the same thing. You don't have a Bible in your hand. Outrage culture. Come on, man. Stop outraging over stuff. If you are getting outraged over anything that hasn't happened to you or somebody directly in your family or your circle, then you should be concerned. You should not be outraging over anything. Because as soon as you're outraging, your head is going, and you have turned into clown shoes. Stop it. You're ruining what should be or the free aspect of our society where people are allowed to be offended and are allowed to say edgy stuff. The whole comedy is being ruined by this PC stuff. And music is next, and it's already starting to happen. People are attacking country music fans and, metal again. I'm just hoping that we're going to get something really, really aggressive and edgy, like punk rock, but new thing to where people are just, and they belt it out and they say whatever they want. And not just like, feminism and blah. Oh, I hate it when. I don't think politics should be in music at all. That's kind of my thing. Even though I'm a musician, I don't put political things in my tunes. I just don't. That's for like hanging out or doing this and having beers with your friends and like shooting the bull. Anyway, so that's kind of where I'm at on this outrage culture stuff. I think it's safe to say I don't like it. I do not care for it much. So, if you enjoy my channel, you enjoy my videos, you like what you heard, you enjoy the content, please go like, subscribe, hit the bell to help my channel grow because the algorithms, when you like it helps my channel grow and I can get more cool stuff done. And please leave your comments down below. Always appreciate that comment section. Watch you guys talk it out a little bit. Give me your ideas. What do you think of outrage culture? Is it helping us overall, or is it causing more of a problem? The question lies within you. So, until next time, I am the Mad Hooter. Defend the faith.